First of all, I promise I will not make any of you cry in the next 5 minutes. But before I get started, I want to say thank you to all of you, Rotary. This is an excellent opportunity. This kind of introspection that you've offered us students around the county is really rare in today's society, so I really thank you for that. Humanity lives for a rush, be it the mellow tingling we receive after seeing our crush or the pounding drumbeat of adrenaline. Our lives revolve around chasing our addictions to those euphoric highs. And when it comes to addiction, no high is more ubiquitous than success. Success, that drug which drives athletes and pencil pushers alike, is derived from being the best. And unlike pills and hard liquor, we are taught from the moment we are born that being the best is the singular addiction that must be chased. It may start with moms comparing their babies' developmental milestones and then snowball into leaderboards and little league tournaments. Either way, we develop a taste for gold medals and the number one. We are taught to never be satisfied until we are deemed the best, as if the only important place on a mountain is its peak. This creates a little problem, though. The rest of us. If being the best is supposed to give us satisfaction, what happens to the 99% that simply aren't the greatest? There's only so much room at the top, after all. So are we to never find bliss unless it's at the expense of the majority? Why should obtaining the ultimate fulfillment be a solo sport? Max began asking these questions to himself not too long ago. At the time, life had decided to stop playing so nice and start making his life a little meaningless. Max had always been the smart kid, that is, until life decided that it was time to knock his top of the class status down several notches. Max was a good swimmer, but life thought he just wasn't fast enough to swim with the fast kids anymore. Now, Max is no longer standing proudly on the mountaintop. He is grappling onto the cliff face below, struggling to hang on. Excellence is not being the best. It is being your best. That quote, stickered to the back of a car Max saw one morning, truly resounded with him. That sticker, as its name implies, stuck with him. He found himself thinking about its meaning in class and at home, and even in the hallowed sanctum of his dreams. Finally, he reached an epiphany. It turns out that the sticker was the shining lure that could pull Max out of the cold, dark depths of uncertainty. Max realized that he didn't need to be what is best to be satisfied. A trophy or certificate doesn't release dopamine. The brain already does that for us. By tweaking his worldview, Max was able to find his satisfaction, his success in everything he did. He swam with his head down forward so as to not look beside and needlessly compare himself to others. By doing that, he became faster than ever before. He learned to quit comparing his GPA to others and just be happy being himself. Max discovered a whole new world of possibilities once he pulled the veil off of success as well. He found that every color seemed brighter and every laugh fuller when he didn't worry himself with trivial rat races. He was able to take a look around and see that he was surrounded by friends in every corner of his life. At one point, Max was barely hanging on. He took a leap off the mountain and found himself soaring. Now, he doesn't need to climb to the top. Instead, he has learned to fly. I have learned to fly.